some GTA Free Roam number 2. And I've just found this really funny song. You can I sing songs or something.
I love you.
That's my family tree. So when I see him a tree, nobody know, nobody know. That's my family tree. That's my family tree. I'm running around for something tree. Nobody know, nobody even company. I'm running around for company. I'm running around for company. Company.
Same old place and still thank God for every breath I take. Mid-June where I grew up before I...
What happened?
Home, I do my shoes up. No spots, just hugs from my crew, love. When we roll to a show, we don't queue up. They wanna act like we're friends and they know us. Quick drop from Nike, they love us. You're the type of person I trust, no questions asked. We just always show up. That's my family tree. That's my family tree. No bad vibes, just good energy.
Nobody know, nobody know. That's my family tree. That's my family tree. It's a free second tree. Nobody know.
I'm on the clock. What you want? Some wheels? It's coming at you.
Don't have enough money. Trying to do hard to get the money.
What?
I'm so close. Yeah. That's my family.
Listen, this is Tony Prince. I'll cut straight to the chase. I heard you were a savvy investor, shall we say? Yes, I like that. A savvy investor. I'm not such a savvy investor. I was going to open up a chain of venues, only that's all gone to shit. Again. But head over to foreclosures.macebank.com and buy one out of foreclosure.
Shut up! I'm burning my head. You found another one, but I'm a bad one. Get me. Can't do it, bro, but I don't need to cross the maze. Did you just bonk my head? I'm the better one, I won't let you forget me.
I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you. And I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Is it your sins and I thought you were the one listening to my heart instead of my head? You found another one, but I am the better one. I won't let you forget me. I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you.
So fresh and fun is the fact that Epic Games are always adding new content to the game. Sometimes they add new weapons, other times they add new areas of the map, but most often they add new skins and emotes. What you might not have realized is that a lot of those emotes are actually based off of things in real life. And in this video, we'll be taking a look at the top 10 Fortnite dances in real life. Legend has it, if you like this video and subscribe to Arcade Cloud, Epic Games will actually put your favorite dance move into Fortnite next. So don't forget to like and subscribe. Again, it's all, you know, it's what ifs. What if?
Number 10, original dance.
Of all the dances in Fortnite to have been based off of something IRL, you might not expect the original default dance to be one of them. I mean, who even uses the original dance anymore, right? Why would they take the effort to base the original dance off of something cool if no one was going to use it when other dances and emotes came out in the future? Well, it turns out that the original default dance was actually based off of something. And I guess someone on the Epic Games team that works on Fortnite must be a pretty big fan of the TV show Scrubs. The emote is actually called Dance Moves, and when you look at the both of them, you can tell that the Fortnite dance was basically taken straight out of the show Scrubs. The dance itself is taken from episode 9 of season 5 of Scrubs, which is an episode called My Half Acre. It's all about JD finding a new girlfriend and Turk joining the Air Hospital band. From the arm cross at the end to the other moves in the dance, it is pretty clear that the dance Turk does and the dance in Fortnite are pretty much exactly the same. Now, what you might not have actually known is that Turk's dance is already a reference to something else completely. In the dance, Turk actually uses a whole bunch of moves from the music video of a song called Poison by Belle Biv DeVoe. Which I guess means that the default dance is a sort of double reference to both Turk and Scrubs in that music video.
Poison. Number 9. Take the L.
The movie It from 2017 is remembered for a whole number of reasons. It's remembered for being an awesome horror movie based off of an awesome book. It's remembered for having some really talented child actors that are probably going to end up being stars in the future. It's even remembered as having some pretty good special effects.
Hey, Paige Harris here. You and me should do this. It makes sense. Buy the terabyte truck on Warstock, we turn it into a nerve center, and start taking scores. I've got some great ideas, I just need someone to execute them.
Dance is pretty much exactly the same as the dance that Pennywise does in the movie It, with only one major difference. In the movie, Pennywise has both of his arms down doing a kind of up and down pumping motion, But in the Fortnite version of the dance, only one arm does that. You must have settled it with your hand held in a pretty clear pattern, which is where the dance gets its name from. What better way to taunt your enemies than combining a loser sign with a dance that was first done by Murder's Clown from another dimension?
Number 8. Fresh.
If you haven't seen The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, then I kind of have to wonder what you've been doing with your life. Sure, it came out in the 90s, which I guess the football dance is a sort of double reference to both Turk and Scrubs, and that music video.
Number 9. Take the L.
The movie It from 2017 is remembered for a whole number of reasons. It's remembered for being an awesome horror movie based off of an awesome book. It's remembered for having some really talented child actors that are probably going to end up being stars in the future. It's even remembered as having some pretty good special effects. Oh, and it's remembered for that stupid dance Pennywise the Clown does towards the end of the movie. Near the end, when he is one of the kids trapped in his evil lair, Pennywise tries to spook them with a really dumb dance. He sort of bounces up and down on the spot, and his legs kicking out at strange angles, and his head staying almost perfectly still. It's a dance that was first turned into a meme, and then eventually turned into a Fortnite emote. The Fortnite dance is pretty much exactly the same as the dance that Pennywise does in the movie It, with only one major difference. In the movie, Pennywise has both of his arms down, doing a kind of up and down pumping motion. But in the Fortnite version of the dance, only one arm does that. The other is held up with your hand held in a pretty clear L, which is where the dance gets its name from. What better way to taunt your enemies than combining a loser sign with a dance that was first done by Murder's Clown?
Let's not push.
Number 8. Fresh.
If you haven't seen The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, then I kind of have to wonder what you've been doing with your life. Sure, it came out in the 90s, but it's an iconic TV show that pretty much defined a generation of TV, and it gave Will Smith a serious boost in his career. However, despite all the incredibly good moments in that show, the thing people most remember is something that Will Smith didn't even come up with. I am, of course, talking about the Carlton dance. The first time we see the dance is actually in the season 2 episode Christmas Snow, and it was completely made up by Carlton's actor, Alfonso Ribeiro. All the script said was Carlton dances, and Alfonso was left to make up his own dance basically on the spot. What we ended up with was a dance that was remembered for years, and is, of course, now in Fortnite. In Fortnite, the dance is called Fresh, so there could be no mistake about what it's trying to reference. Just like the Carlton dance from the show, this dance is all about those big, exaggerated, swinging arm movements. It looks pretty good, and considering the original dance was just made up in a really short time for a TV show in the 90s, it's pretty cool to see how much it has managed to persist through the years, even making it into one of the biggest video games in the world.
Number 7, Floss.
While Fortnite Battle Royale is played by people of all ages, it's pretty obvious that the game was made for kids. The lack of blood and gore, as well as the cartoony aesthetic of the graphics, are all perfect for players of a young age. So it makes sense that some of the emotes and dances in the game cater more to references that kids will get rather than the adult audience.
One of those dances game Floss is huge.
And it's based on a dance by someone that you probably better recognize as being called Backpack Kid. In real life, the dance move is called the Russell, because the kid's name is actually Russell Horney, though it is known as flossing. People probably best know Backpack Kid as being the kid who did his dance on SNL alongside Katy Perry. The dance is pretty simple. Just swing your arms around your body while shaking your hips and keeping a seriously straight face. The dance in Fortnite is exactly the same, although Backpack Kid can do it much faster.
Number 6, Electro Shuffle.
Imagine being a YouTuber, and then out of nowhere having your dance moves be put into Fortnite Battle Royale. It would be a pretty big honor, and it would bring a whole load of more followers to your YouTube channel. Well, that is exactly what happened to a YouTuber called Gabby J. David with the Electro Shuffle Dance. The Electro Shuffle Dance is pretty clearly based off of her video, Bad and Bougie Shuffle Shapes, which was uploaded to YouTube on the 26th of January, 2017. Fortnite didn't take the entire dance that Gabby came up with, but it's pretty obvious that part of the dance was taken basically directly from Gabby's video. I have to be honest here and say that I am pretty impressed. When I first saw the Fortnite dance, I thought it would be pretty tough to do in real life, and that people would be trying and failing to get it right for quite a while. To find out that it was actually designed by someone in real life, rather than some animator who didn't realize how unlikely it would be to do that dance in reality, is pretty surprising and incredibly impressive.
Number 5. Reanimated.
He's coming down.
The reanimated dance is probably one of the coolest dances in Fortnite Battle Royale at the moment. You start off by kind of acting like you're dead, slumping over like your body has lost all control, before springing back up to life and doing some very clearly Michael Jackson-style Thriller-inspired dance moves.
before Freeler!
Like you're a member of the recently reanimated undead. While this dance is very clearly inspired by Michael Jackson's iconic Thriller dance at times,
Skeletor saved the money supermarket, and now he feels epic!
There's other moves that come from another place entirely, though they're still real dance moves. It isn't totally the same, but some of the moves, like the jerking all over the place and shaking your arms, are pretty obviously taken from a Korean dance group called Necrophilia. The group who came up with this dance have obviously watched a load of zombie movies to try and nail the moves that a zombie might make, and it ends up coming together really well. The music in Fortnite is also pretty much exactly the same as the music from the dance show in real life, so there's no doubt that this is the same dance.
Number 4. Disco Fever.
First released in 1977, the movie Saturday Night Fever is another iconic piece of media from the past. It follows the story of Tony Manero, a 19-year-old Italian-American from Brooklyn, who is trying to escape his day-to-day life by going to a local disco club called 2001 Odyssey. With a movie centered around a disco club, you would expect there to be a lot of dancing. And with John Travolta playing Anthony Manero, fans were not disappointed. Disco Fever is a dance that is taken straight from the movie, and it is pretty instantly recognizable as using moves that people instantly associate with the disco genre. I mean, who hasn't seen that pointing dance move at least once, right? I have to admit that the dance in Saturday Night Fever is actually a lot better than the version that ended up being in Fortnite Battle Royale. Travolta is just a lot more fluid and stylish than the Fortnite version. But hey, that doesn't mean that the Fortnite dance is bad. It's still got quite a lot of that classic disco flair.
Number 3. Ride That Pony.
In 2012, the world was taken by storm by a song that we all now know as Gangnam Style. Since the video's official release back in 2012, it has managed to rack up over 3.1 billion views on YouTube. And although that is no longer the most views on a YouTube video, it was the first YouTube video in history to manage to get over a billion views. One of the most iconic dance moves in the entire music video is the kind of cowboy dance style, where Psy acts as if he's on a horse trying to lasso another animal. That dance move has been recreated in Fortnite Battle Royale as a move called Ride the Pony.
Ride
the Pony is exactly what you expect it to be. You bounce up and down in one spot and act as if you are getting ready to lasso something, just like Psy does in Gangnam Style. With so many views on the video, and considering how much of a hit the song became, it really isn't surprising that Fortnite would want to put that into their game.
Number 2. Best Beats.
Oh, we're still streaming. How am I still streaming? Ground Team. Hat is pilot.
And one of the most recognizable of them all is the Best Mates Dance. Added in Season 3, the Best Mates Dance is pretty simple. Just run on the spot and swing your arms back and forth. But it has a pretty interesting history that can be dated back to a pretty hilarious video. The dance was originally uploaded by a content creator on Facebook called Marlon Webb, who has since become a pretty big hit with his skits and comedy videos. Just like the Fortnite dance, in this video, Marlon jogs around the place, swinging his arms and lifting his knees up super high. Since the original video, though, this dance has been recreated by a ton of people. If you have ever gone to a comic convention, then there's a pretty high chance that you've seen whole chains of people doing the Best Mates dance in a strange sort of conga line. The most watched version of this is probably a video by Impact Props called The Band of the Spartans from back in 2016. Much to the confusion of pretty much everyone at the convention, a whole group of Halo cosplayers got together to do the Best Mates dance, all three of them running along behind one another. Since that point in time, more and more people have gotten involved in the meme, with crazy scenes like tons of Star Wars cosplayers all doing the dance at the same time. Epic put it in anyway. But there is a dark twist in the story of Marlon's dance.
It doesn't matter.
It's not a digital fucking
right.
clock.
All right. Do it. Bam! There we go. Did that work? Is that working?
The clock is moving. The clock is moving. It's at 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. We missed the 35.
I stopped it.
That?
30.
Come on, you can do this. 33, 34.
Oh, God.
Come on.
No!
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 What?
No! He did 36.
We're at 933.
I had one on Friday. Well, I had one on Friday. Why? Say, can I have one at night time? Well, I'm not doing it now.
Back to
lava. Oh god. No, that's not gonna happen. That's just more sounds. I'm fucked.
Hey, in a minute. Let me do this first. I'm playing. I have to do this. I can't because I did not get a little money. I have to get it.
Go,
I have to stop the stream now, I'm sorry.